desprecio, which ends.
Okay, good.
Which ends to control yes. The entire life cycle of.
Run software update.
Installation or configuration, every possible change that can show up during the life of your infrastructure in terms of changes of policies, changes of mission, everything. Inventory, and we are also doing some work on the commissioning of the hosts. The key points of focus on correctness. You have to catch any configuration mistakes as soon as possible, if possible, before deploying your configurations. Because it's terrible if you ship an invalid file and suddenly your entire farm goes down. We are for reproducibility, we have to reproduce our results, we have to be able to replay our history, we have to be able to investigate when things go wrong and go back easily if we make a mistake. We want to scale, so we have a major banking institution that is running over 35,000 Linux boxes, and they are introducing 10,000 Linux boxes. It has to scale up, and it's much more important to scale up than to scale down. It's to be modular. If you want to scale up, you have to allow your users to choose as much or as little as they need. They have internal procedures, and we don't want to get in their way. Traceable security in this environment is paramount. So, in order to provide that, in order to guarantee correctness and reproducibility, we have developed a declarative language called Para, and we give a little taste of it, that allows us to describe every relevant portion of a host. If you want to control the accounts, you will describe your accounts in this language. And on top, after that, we have a number of tools that are aimed to run the managed machines, and they will align the state of the host to the desired state, to the state that you have expressed in the PAN language. There are three key components in the Quattro architecture. You have all your managed nodes, all your fabric. You have a configuration management database, and James will talk about a very cool implementation later. Basically, the model is you produce PAN code, it gets compiled in the configuration management database, and it's served via HTTP. And then the installation infrastructure and the managed fleet are going to consume HTTP files. And scaling up this HTTP is already a solved problem. And adding security layers with HTTP is also a solved problem. It's something that we already know how to do. The PAN language, she said, it's declarative. You don't want to send commands to 10,000 hosts. You don't want to send them install something. Because if one host is down, it will become inconsistent. You want to declare the state. You want to say, this is your latest list of packages. And then they will consume that that state, and they will have to do something to run. So we have a language that gives us that declaration. It allows the system administrators to declare their own data types, their own consistency constraints, including cross-references between portions of the configuration or between clients and servers, guarantee consistency and clients and servers. And a very simple example would be to restrict a given string to have a well-known set of values. Recent project, as I said, there are tools in the whatever is relevant for you. It's not relevant for you, you just leave it out. for the microphone configuration with your existing procedures. The installation, we try not to reinvent the wheel, and since we are currently supported distribution is Red Hat and derivatives, we do the installation via Kickstart and PLC. And again, if you want to use Quadro for installing your hosts, you declare everything that is relevant in the profile, the file systems, the partitions. I think our Kickstart generator is the only one so far that can do LVM software write, LVM on top of software write, arbitrary stacks that I haven't found in any other tools. We don't support installation over IPv6, but no site in the community has came with that request. If somebody needs it, it can be discussed. Very easy to add. Writing plugins is easy. If you have a cool new service, you have a very simple API and you have to come with a description of your service and match it to the behavior on the node. If your workflow is write a file and restart the demo, which is very frequent, we have generic plugins to do that. And if you have something that is more convoluted, that requires a more complicated logic, well, your plugin will be as difficult as the logic for your service. There is no big problem there. However, the downside of this order, and if you use Quadro, if you use Puppet, if you use whatever, is that you are requiring system administrators, service managers, people who may be very, very smart at their job, at their mission, but they are not coders, and you are asking them to write code. And your infrastructure is only as good as the code that you are providing. So you will need some way of having a code review, you will need to teach them how to do code, and that can be very expensive. James is going to talk about a way of addressing that. If you have any questions, you can contact us in quadro.org, and you'll see all the mailing lists and follow us in Google Plus.
So you say that Quadro is configuration management on that. I'm not sure as much of your mind share on acronyms or blocking sites. How might you compare it with say Puppet?
So Puppet, the language is not it aims to be declarative, but the language is not as strongly typed and it doesn't put that much effort into validating the configuration before deployment. So there are some odds that you will get the redeployment of the configuration. That's the first downside. The other side, we intend that the only source of truth is the profile that is compiled, whereas Puppet is more chatty. Tries to send out facts from the node to the server, and the server will tell you what to do next. I think it's lighter in that regard. The Quadro model is lighter.
Hey, yeah, I'm totally new to it, but I never heard of it. But I read the description, and it sounds very interesting. So, could you give me a very simple overview of how what Qatar exactly does for services, for example? Because in your example with the PC deployment, you say like you write for Kickstarter files and like Red Hat like distributions. So it can be cross platform, can you define any service? Can you deploy Windows services?
You can use it for inventory, and our biggest user is using for inventory. We currently don't try to manage Windows services, we don't try to manage the DNA hosts. It started in the LHC computing grid, so and the requirement there was to support the Red Hat derivatives, and that's where we focused and we became very specialized in that. It's very easy to port part. You need one plugin for your configuration manager and maybe one plugin for your network configuration.
So
closed maintenance because people say that better to mark the rules offline in other ways, maybe just sending a command over PDSH instead of altering the status declaration, which is a little bit worse than.
More questions?
Yes. I'm just curious, how do you populate the configuration management database? How do you interact with it?
That's James Hope. He will show you.
Stick around.
All right.
Now.
Do you have a specification document for your configuration language somewhere?
Yes, it should be a source for Italian.
There
should be we have a full book with exercises. It's simple and the book goes in very detailed. It's similar to what's similar to seeing in the
license.
The new code is Apache license. The old code is European Data Grid license, which is a PDSH.
That's it. Were you giving it demo as well, or is it?
Yes.
You still have time. So. Before here was the Debian maps. They have their own thing.
So is FactorRight more sort of big grids which are relatively homogenous and you just say, right, we're installing Red Hat Linux everywhere rather than we've got 10,000 machines and 3,000 for one variety of Linux and a couple of Macs and some Windows and they're already different applications. Is that different use case?
That's the main purpose is to make your fabric as homogeneous as possible. Sometimes it's obvious that it's not possible to be fully homogeneous because of different needs and different support requirements. But tools that require Debian or Windows, they usually come with their own management systems. With Windows, you really have to be interactive and you have to do things in a way that is sort of approved by Microsoft. So we didn't have.
It has been done.
Yeah, it has been done, but it's mostly for later
years. Yeah. Well, historically, yes, that's quite always designed to shape more data modules to improve versions. It's not meant to be doing other things. Just an example.
So, if you want to have some daemon started, you can you define it with this line. Here you can have the consistency checks. Have I enabled the Hyper-V configurations or not? And then I will start this configuration. So the language is very good and using recipes in your site is trivial and sharing them with the rest of the community is also very easy. It's all meant for sharing configurations very, very happy. And then if compiling something else will show it to you, it's an IP compile as a sandbox.
That should be one.
compilation phase, and this puts the file, the compiled object in the, under the control of the web server, and it sends notifications to all the nodes so that they will download the profile. And if the notification gets lost, no problem. There are other ways for the node to still consume the profile.